Well, first of all, I do want to give thanks to my Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. Without him, I would not be here today. Growing up, my family, my parents did a great job raising my sister and I with values and morals and taking us to church and telling us about God and teaching us about him the best that they could. But at an early age of 14, I decided to take my own way. And for 17 years, I battled a long, struggling drug and alcohol addiction. It tore my family apart. It hurt everyone that loved me, around me. I struggled, and I was godless. I was mindless. I caused pain and suffering in everyone's life. But I will say that on May 17th of 2013, I no longer had to run anymore. By the grace of God, I was arrested, and God put me in the Bridges of Iowa program, which it's changed my life. And I met Lori Tashner, who I believe was no accident. She was an inspiration to me. She invited me to Sailorville. I took Lori in, and she had everything I wanted. I wanted to live life and see life like she did. I wanted to know what she knew and knows. And I came to Sailorville. She also introduced me to Pastor Chuck's Bible studies, which just I knew right then I needed the Lord. And I knew I wanted to I knew once I went to membership class, I wanted to become a member of a Bible teaching church. And I took everything that Lori had given me and the church had done for me into heart, and I on October 3rd of 2013, I surrendered to the Lord. I dropped to my knees and I asked him to come into my life and into my heart and to fill me with the Holy Spirit, and he did. And I have been tested and tempted, and I've been convicted. And I pray a prayer all the time just for him to come into my heart and to fill me with the Holy Spirit, because I need him. I need him in my life to stay clean, to stay sober. I need him to live life. I can't live life without him. And I now know this. And I do have a scripture that has helped me through a lot of this, and it is Romans 10, 9 through 11. If you confess that Jesus is Lord and believe that God raised him from death, you will be saved. For it is by faith that we are put right with God, but it is by our confession that we are saved. And that verse has helped me, and I read it every night. I'm thankful, and I give all the glory to the Lord Jesus Christ. He is my Savior.
Amen. Amen, Summer. Summer, it's a joy to have not been directly involved in your life other than preaching to you week in and week out over these last several months, but to watch you go from being sort of a deer in the headlights when you first came with Lori to having God literally open your eyes to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a blessing. And to have you read this scripture from Romans 10, 9, and 10, which is, I just read that to somebody the other day and watched God just melt their hearts. That if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. You called on the Lord. It's evident that you've trusted Jesus as Savior. You're honest about your struggles, but you're grateful for the victory you have in Christ, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Praise the Lord. Well, let's thank God for Summer, shall we? Our Father, we thank you so much for the testimony of Summer. What a blessing to hear. What a marvelous work, again, Lord, of grace that you have done in this young woman's life. And it's just wonderful to behold. Thank you for people, Lord, that you bring into those like Summer's lives, like Lori and the Bridges of Iowa program, and just all these circumstances that Summer has already acknowledged, Lord, they're not happenstance. They're not coincidences. You have providentially done these things in your determination to save this young woman. And now, Lord, help her, bless her, Continue to fill her with your Holy Spirit, as she mentioned earlier. Give her victory and strength. Help her, Lord, to be a living testimony for Jesus Christ now and for the entirety of her life, reaching out to friends and others alike, Lord, for your glory. Bless her so much, Lord, for her act of obedience here in baptism as well. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Summer, thank you for sharing your story. And upon your profession of faith and in obedience to God's word, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.